That'd be nice. I wish we could too.
Sorry. Well, well, well. Look at the two of you, thick as thieves.
Oh, now my day is really made.
Lucy, do you know I actually missed your boring cliches? Let me tell you a little secret. I didn't miss you at all, and I'm here strictly on hospital business.
Really?
Yes, really. As you've probably heard because you hear everything, I have been made executive director of the spa, and I'm here to pick up medical waiver forms for our clientele.
How nice.
Very nice. Now, will you scurry off and get them for me, please?
I'll be right back.
I'm not going anywhere.
Dominique, I certainly hope I wasn't interrupting anything between the two of you.
Would you really care if you were?
No. You know, I don't mean to offend you, but you actually look rather awful.
Oh, really?
About a minute ago, I was just fine.
No, no, really. You look very, very pale, kind of.
Buzz off, Lucy.
Well, pale and touchy today, aren't we? You know, I might suggest you visit Tom Hardy, but no, I can't suggest that. I guess you've already done the psychiatric routine, haven't
you? Shut up, all right?
Will you just shut up? I am here for simple medical tests. Are you satisfied?
Test? What kind of tests?
It's none of your business.
Tell me something, Dominique. Are you feeling a bit faint?
Lucy, just go away, okay?
No, you know, I'm a lot smarter than you think I am, and I happen to know the signs very well. You are pregnant, aren't you?
What?
That's it. That's what this whole thing is all about. I get it now. You got yourself knocked up just so Scott would marry you.
You know, I don't know why I'm having this conversation.
You know, I can't believe that I actually let Scott make me think that he loved you and that's why he married you. He just had to marry you. This is such a joke. It's turned out to be a big fat joke.
There's no getting through to you, is there? You are warped.
I am not warped. You should listen to what I have to say. Scott is going to hate being tied to your apron strings and playing the happy little husband, and he's going to hate the fact that you tricked him.
I give up.
You know, if you had some brains, you would listen, and you would come clean with Scott, because he is going to leave you alone. He doesn't like fatherhood, and he doesn't want to be hung up changing diapers, and you're going to be doing it all by yourself.
Say goodbye, Lucy.
Lucy, Amy.
Hi.
Hi.
Come on, talk to me. You look like you lost your best friend. I can't believe that I'm doing this.
Well, I'm sorry then. You know, I didn't ask you to come over, so why don't you go on?
Okay, fine. You can't say I didn't try here.
Fine.
Goodbye.
Fine, goodbye. Scott. All right, if you insist, then I will tell you.
Fine.
Fine. This is hard.
Well, spit it out.
Okay, it's us.
Us? There is no us.
I get that. Now, okay, I understand. You've been trying to tell me that since I got back into town, and now I understand. It's dead, it's over, it's kaput, it's just finished.
Are we playing a game here?
No. I just have realized that you have made a new little life with your new little wife, and...
And what?
And I am going to make a new life for myself, and while there is no room in your life for me, there is certainly no room in my life for you.
So here we go. We are playing games here.
Or a big bozo. You wouldn't know the truth if it hit you over the head.
Wait.
Look, I'm not going to waste my breath, okay? I'm just going to say this once. We are history. Finished. Scott Ballin, goodbye. For good.
Goodbye. That's a good one.
Marco, I'm surprised. Your hands are better than I thought they'd be.
But could you say that a little louder, please, for the listening audience out here?
Marco. A little higher.
Oh, well, there you are.
You
found your way in.
Yes.
Colleen is going to be your masseuse today, and she is one of our best. I think you'll really enjoy it.
Okay, if you say so. All right, thank you.
Well, may I say, nice, very, very nice.
You know, I really think that Tracy's loss is Lady's gain everywhere.
Lucy, unfortunately, I'm not available, and your reputation does precede you, doesn't it?
Oh, here's Colleen. Colleen, just in the nick of time.
Right.
Paul? Colleen, Paul, she does have the best hands in the business, so I will leave you two to do it.
Thanks, Lucy. Great. I suppose you want me on...
Yeah, I'd like to start with you on your stomach.
Okay.
Okay, and if you have any especially tense areas, you just let me know and I'll work
them out. Well, it's just sort of a general overall tension, you know, Colleen.
Well, don't worry. I'm sure that you'll leave here feeling like a new man. You ready?
I'm ready.
Quiet in there.
Anglos. They just don't know how to have a good time.
Well, Lucy said you were the best. This is great.
I'm not sure about the reference, but I'm very glad you're satisfied.
Jenny!
Surprise!
You planned this, didn't you? Come here. You planned this. Mm.
Honey, it only gets better. Bye now.
I'm all yours. Whatever you say.
Quiet.
What? Down in the car, I think.
Oh.
Yeah, that's good.
That's... You feel so tense with everything that's been going on. Who better to relax you than me?
No. You got strong hands. This is great.
This is going to be some really good stuff.
I think I have a pad over. Have you got a pen somewhere?
Oh.
Yeah, I don't think I realized how tense I was.
Just
that feel good? Oh, yeah, right there. Do it right there. Oh, yeah. Oh, it's good. Mm. God. If you did this for me every day, then Tracy's worst whatever would just roll right off me like water. You know?
Forget about Tracy.
Okay, it shouldn't be too hard.
She's pathetic.
Mm-hmm. She deserves what she gets.
Come on. We're not going to talk about Tracy. Marco!
It's Tracy.
Tracy, you better get out of here now. Come on.
I know you're in there. Come on. You are an absolute living nightmare. You know that?
You haven't seen anything yet, Tom.
I ought to have you arrested, Tracy. You know that?
Fine. I'll make sure they take you, too. You'll be a big hit in the holding tank.
Oh, look. Perfect. Two lowlifes in the same cubicle.
Hi,
what do you
Paul.
Know? Hi.
Speaking
how are you?
Speaking of lowlifes, what were you doing naked on a massage table with her?
It's your imagination, dear. Shouldn't be too
I
hard
will
to
when
out.
I speak to my lawyer and tell him about the public orgy you had.
Not a good idea. I wouldn't do that if I were you, Tracy.
Oh, yeah. Thanks.
Excuse me? I didn't hear you.
I said
are
I
you
wouldn't
threatening
do that.
Me?
Oh, please don't let her get to you.
Oh, little Jennifer to the rescue.
Let's go. Come on,
Jen. You look really good in a massage parlor. Is that where you met the senator?
Andy,
you know, I never liked you very much.
Wait,
leave me alone.
Let me fall.
No,
get her.
Jenny, no. Hey, come on. Jenny,
no. You've been laying in this
house. Here, lady.
What do you think it's like for me?
I should have known it was you behind this whole thing.
Me?
Oh, you know something? I can't wait for you to see the bill you're going to receive from this cleanup operation.
Well, when I see the bill, I'll be glad that I've done this.
Ooh. Wait, just calm down a little bit. It's not all that bad. Look, it's good for your pores.
Oh, you know something? You're going to be very lucky to keep your job, buddy.
What's happened to your sense of humor?
Jenny has a...
You!
That was a creepy...